Buongiorno, I'm Joey, the quarantine cook. After dinner, we're having bowtie pasta with some diced tomatoes, mushrooms, feta cheese, and olives soaked in olive oil and some Italian beans. The first thing you're going to do is you're going to take 4 cups of water and put it in your pot. High. And then you're going to take 2 cups of pasta and you're going to toss it in, just like so. And we're going to have a little bit of olive oil. A little bit of a stir. Stand over here, you're going to toss just a dash of salt in there. Butter into our Italian beans, which have been soaking in water. We've got the butter on high, and after it cooks for a few minutes, we're going to turn that down to probably a low to medium. Cool. Dried mushrooms that were soaking in water, and we want them to clump up really nicely. And then we'll take those and throw it in with our pasta and our tomatoes and olive oil and feta. Salt in with your beans as well. After you boil your pasta for about 10 minutes, what I like to do is put the lid on, turn it on a low heat, and let it absorb some of the water and steam for a couple minutes just to puff the pasta up. Okay, so I'm going to take the lid back off of my pasta for just a second because I want to test it. Now, you don't want it to be al dente, which is fine for the bite, but you don't want it to be mushy either. Perfect. Take this off the burner, and we're going to drain the water out of the pasta. Very carefully. Don't burn yourself. You can use a colander if you want to, but, you know, it's just as easy to do it this way. Alright, perfect. Okay, let's take our mushrooms, which were dry mushrooms, they're all plucked up. We're going to throw them in with the pasta. And you're going to use a spoon, and of course it has holes in it. Kind of liquid. Don't reach it all the way in the bottom of the bowl because you're gonna have sand in deposits. You know, because our mushrooms have been growing in the dirt. So here we go. All right, that's good. So you're gonna take your diced tomatoes next and you're gonna pop those in with the pasta. I love these cans I got from Whole Foods because you can just pop the top off. You don't have to use a can opener. Super simple. Alright, just throw that in with your bow tie. And then you're gonna take the feta and olive oil mixture, which Whole Foods was nice enough to have cut up for us already. Just gotta get the lid off. Make sure you don't get olive oil everywhere because that could be dangerous. Alright, so here's this. And we're just gonna dump that in there. And it's got a lot of spices in it too, so that's gonna make it fantastic. Alright, mixture in together. Wow. Pretty looks fantastic. Alright, you're gonna let that simmer for just a few minutes and then you'll be ready to go. Our green beans are already cooked. Great. Last but not least, you're gonna add some Italian cheese mixture to the top. And you're ready to serve. Buon appetito! I'm Joey, the quarantine cook. Tomorrow we're gonna heat that up because I have enough for leftovers. And one more note before we go today. Make sure that you tell your guests whether or not your olives are pickled or not. That was incredible. The combination of the bowtie pasta, the olives, the feta cheese, and the Italian green beans was